Hello everyone, in this lecture we will discuss about some terms related to butt weld and we will discuss about the design strength of the butt weld. So the first term is reinforcement. So reinforcement is the extra material deposited above the level surface of parent material to be connected. Okay, so here you can see this is the butt weld case, as here these two main plate, or we can say the parent metal. Okay, so here you can see these two plates, these two main plates are aligned in the same plane. Okay, they are aligned end to end each other. That means this is the case of the butt weld. Okay, so this extra material you can see here. Okay, this extra material is deposited above this level surface. Okay, so this extra material which is deposited above the surface of these two parent metal is known as the reinforcement. Okay, so why this extra material is deposited above the surface of the parent metal? Okay, so generally the main purpose is to increase the efficiency. Okay, so as in case of welded connection, we assume that we get 100% efficiency. Okay, so efficiency means, you know, from the welded connection, that is strength of joint. Divided by strength of solid plate. Or we can say main plate or parent metal. Okay, strength of solid plate, or you can say parent metal. Okay, so here this strength of joint is the strength of weld. Okay, here this strength of joint is the strength of weld. But in case of bolted connection, strength of the joint is the minimum of strength of bolt and the rupture strength of the plate. But as in case of welded connection, at the joint there is no holes. Okay, there are no holes, so the plate will not favor under rupture. Okay, so there in case of welded connection there is no rupture failure of the plate. That's why here the strength of joint means only we have to calculate the strength of weld. Okay, so here the efficiency is strength of weld divided by strength of solid plate, or we can say strength of parent material. Okay, so 100% efficiency means strength of weld is equal to strength of solid plate. Okay, 100% efficiency means strength of weld is equal to strength of parent material. Okay, and we assume in case of welded connection that we get 100% efficiency. But practically this strength of weld is generally less than that of the strength of the parent material. That means in practically the efficiency is less than 100%. Okay, so to get 100% efficiency and to increase the strength of weld, this extra material is deposited. Okay, so this extra material means the reinforcement is provided in the welded connection to increase the strength of weld, for which we can get the 100% efficiency. Okay, so that's why this extra material is deposited. Okay, but there is a limitation of this reinforcement. Okay, so we can provide maximum 3 mm. Okay, so this thickness should be maximum 3 mm. Okay, so why there is a limitation of providing this reinforcement up to 3 mm? Okay, because due to repeated load or due to dynamic load, this connection may undergo brittle failure. Okay, so if we increase this weld, then the brittleness of the connection will increase. Okay, so for that reason there is a limitation of providing this reinforcement. So we can provide the reinforcement maximum up to 3 mm. Okay, so this is all about the reinforcement. Then the next term is effective throat thickness. Okay, so effective throat thickness is the shortest distance between the root of weld and the face of the weld. Okay, so effective throat thickness is the shortest distance between the root of weld and the face of weld, or the line which joins the toe of the weld. Okay, so this shortest distance is the effective thickness, effective throat thickness, and here you can see this line connects the toe of this weld. Okay, so for complete penetration, effective throat thickness is equal to thickness of thinner member. Here the effective throat thickness is the shortest distance between the root and the face of the weld, and this effective throat thickness is equal to thickness of thinner member for the complete penetration. Complete penetration means the double U bot joint, double V bot joint and the square bot weld on both sides. These are the case of the complete penetration. Okay, so for in these cases the effective throat thickness will be thickness of the thinner member. That means there are two plates. Okay, let this thickness is 10 mm. Okay, and let the thickness of this plate is 8 mm. Okay, then here the effective throat thickness will be 8 mm, as here between these two plates 8 mm is the minimum thickness. Okay, but for incomplete penetration, effective throat thickness is equal to 5/8 into thickness of thinner member, that is T minimum. Okay, so for incomplete penetration means the single U bot joint, single V bot joint, then square bot weld on one side, these are the case of the incomplete penetration. Okay, so for incomplete penetration the effective throat thickness will be 5/8 into T minimum. T minimum means thickness of the thinner member. So for this case, let the effective throat thickness will be 5/8. So here you can see this is the case of the incomplete penetration. Okay, so here this will be 5 by 8 into t minimum. Here you can see that the thickness of one plate is 10 mm and the thickness of another plate is 8 mm. So 8 mm is the minimum thickness. Okay, so the for minimum so for incomplete penetration the effective throat thickness will be 5 mm. Okay, so these are some provisions for effective throat thickness. Then next term is size of welt. For bot weld, remember that the size of weld is equal to effective throat thickness. Okay, so for bot weld, we can take the size of weld equal to effective throat thickness. Okay, so for complete penetration, size of weld will be thickness of thinner member. As for complete penetration, effective throat thickness is equal to thickness of thinner member. So for complete penetration, the size of weld is equal to effective throat thickness is equal to thickness of thinner member. And for incomplete penetration, size of weld is equal to effective throat thickness is equal to 5 by 8 into minimum thickness of thinner member. Okay, so remember that for bot weld, we will take the size of weld as effective throat thickness. Okay, but this condition will be different for fillet weld. Okay, so this condition, that is size of weld is equal to effective throat thickness, this condition is only for bot weld. Okay, then the next term is length of weld. So length of weld means the total length of weld provided. Okay, let these are two members and we have provided the butt weld here throughout its width. Okay, so this width will be the length of the weld. Okay, so length of weld means length of full size weld provided. Okay, then the next term is area, effective area of weld. So this effective area of weld is equal to size of weld into length of weld provided. Okay, so we know that size of weld is equal to effective throat thickness. So in place of size of weld, we can write the effective throat thickness into length of weld. Okay, so in this way the area of weld is calculated, that is effective throat thickness into length of weight provided. Okay, so for complete penetration this will be the thickness of thinner member, and for incomplete penetration this effective throat thickness will be 5/8 into thickness of thinner member. Then come to design strength of boat weld. Okay, so generally boat weld resists the load due to tension, compression and the shearing action. Okay, so due to three actions, that is the tension, compression and shear action, the boat weld resists the load. Okay, so the design strength of boat weld in tension and compression, in tension and compression so generally design strength of weld means we are going to calculate the load carrying capacity of the joint. Okay, so generally remember that in case of bolted connection also we are calculating the strength of bolt, means the load carrying capacity of the bolt, okay, and the load carrying capacity of the joint. So generally load is what? Stress into area. So strength of weld, design strength of weld into effective area of weld. So this is design stress of weld. Okay, we are going to calculate the design strength of weld. So here the strength is generally the load carrying capacity. So load is generally stress into area. So here also design stress of weld into effective area of weld. Okay, so here this design stress of weld is Fy divided by gamma Mw, okay, into area of weld. Okay, so here Fy is the yield stress of the material or yield stress of the weld. Here you can see, here you can write yield stress of weld or steel member. Okay, here Fy is the yield stress of weld or member, or you can write the material. So generally yield stress of the material is 250 MPa, that is 250 Newton per mm square. Okay, and gamma Mw is the partial factor of safety for weld, and this value you can get from table number 5. Okay, so this value you can get from the table number 5. Then next come to area of weld. Okay, so area of weld is size of weld into effective length of weld, or the length of weld provided. Okay, so area of weld equal to size of weld into length of weld provided, and the size of weld for butt weld, the size of weld is equal to effective throat thickness. So in place of size of weld, we can write the effective throat thickness into length of weld. Okay, so this is the formula for area of weld. Okay, so here in case of area of weld, you can write effective throat thickness into length of weld provided. Okay, so in this way you can calculate the design strength of the boat weld in case of tension or compression. Okay, and you can also calculate the design strength of boat weld in shear. As the boat weld resists the load due to tension, compression and shear action. So this formula is for the tension and compression that we have discussed. The next is design strength of boat weld in shear. Okay. So in shear, the design strength of weld will be same, that is FIW divided by gamma MW. The extra thing is here you need just divide the root 3 here, okay, into area of weld. Here also area of weld is effective throat thickness into length of weld provided. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate the design strength of boat weld in shear. Okay, so the formula is almost same, just here this root 3 is the extra part. Okay, just divide the root 3 here. Okay, so this much all about today's class, and in the next class we will solve an analytical problem related to boat weld. Okay, thank you.